Hello students, welcome you all once again. In this video, I am going to start a new lesson from organic chemistry and the name of the lesson is ethers and epoxides. What is that students? Ethers and epoxides. Okay, so let us look at the introduction of this chapter. So first, what are ethers? Which organic compound is called as an ether? Ethers are nothing but the organic compounds having two alkyl groups attached to an oxygen atom. Okay, the organic compounds which contain two alkyl groups attached to an oxygen atom are called ethers. Okay. So you can also write two alkyl groups or two aryl groups or one alkyl and one aryl group. Okay, you can add that also to the definition of ethers. Okay, I have mentioned only two alkyl groups here. So write down the definition, students. The organic compounds which contain two alkyl groups or two aryl groups or one alkyl and one aryl group attached to an oxygen atom are called as ethers. Understood, students? So two alkyl groups can be attached or two aryl groups can be attached or one alkyl and one aryl group also can be attached to an oxygen atom in an ether. Okay, now they are regarded as dialkyl derivatives of water or monoalkyl derivatives of alcohols. What is the meaning of dialkyl derivatives of water? What is the formula of water? H2O. Okay, you can write it as HOH. If the two hydrogens in the water molecule are replaced by two alkyl groups, then it becomes an ether, and hence ethers are also regarded as dialkyl derivatives of water. Understood, students? Water is HOH. If the two hydrogens are replaced by two alkyl groups, then it becomes an ether, na? So hence ether can be regarded as dialkyl derivatives of water or monoalkyl derivatives of alcohols. Tell me, what is an alcohol? Alcohol is ROH. Okay, there is one hydrogen in alcohol. If that hydrogen is replaced by an alkyl group, then it becomes ROR. Understood? Okay, therefore ethers can also be regarded as monoalkyl derivatives of alcohols. Don't miss even a single word of mine. Okay, so if you listen to each and every word carefully, it will be very, very easy for you to understand. Okay, students, ethers are regarded as dialkyl derivatives of water or monoalkyl derivatives of alcohols. Underline this point. Next, what is their general formula? Their general formula is ROR dash. Okay, ROR dash. I told you in the beginning, R and R dash might be two alkyl groups or two aryl groups or one alkyl and one aryl group. Okay, they can also be called as anhydrides of alcohols. Tell me, what is an anhydride of alcohol? How do we get anhydride of alcohol? Look at the reaction below. I have taken two molecules of alcohols, ROH plus RH. Remove water from these two alcohols, HOH. If you remove, we get ROR plus H2O. Okay, so these many names ethers possess, hence we can call ethers by all these names. Okay, understood, students? The first paragraph. Next, ethers are of how many types? Two types. They are simple and mixed ethers. Simple ethers can also be called as symmetrical ethers. What are the simple ethers? In simple ethers, both the alkyl groups attached to the oxygen atom are identical. Look at the examples given below. CH3OCH3. Both the alkyl groups are similar. Next, C2H5OC2H5. So both the alkyl groups are identical. What is CH3OCH3 called as? These are two methyl groups. Hence, it is called as dimethyl ether. What is C2H5OC2H5 called as? These two are ethyl groups and hence diethyl ether, or simply it can be called as ether. Okay, students, understood? Next, second one, mixed or unsymmetrical ethers. So, in the above type, that is simple ethers, both the alkyl groups attached to the oxygen atom are identical. Mixed ethers are nothing but opposite to simple ethers. Understood? So, in this, both the alkyl groups attached to the oxygen atom are different. Look at the examples given below. CH3OC2H5, ethyl, methyl, ether. C2H5OC3H7, ethyl, propyl, ether. Okay, students, the two alkyl groups attached are different in mixed ethers. They are also called as unsymmetrical ethers. Okay. Next, nomenclature of ethers. So, how do we name ethers? First one, let us see the common system. In common system, ethers are named according to the alkyl groups attached to the oxygen atoms. The two alkyl or aryl groups attached to the functional group, that is O, are written alphabetically followed by the word ether. Try to understand it, students. The two alkyl or aryl groups attached to the oxygen atom are written alphabetically followed by the word ether. So, let me explain you with an example here. Below, CH3OCH3. Okay. So, these two are methyl groups. So, no confusion. We can write easily dimethyl ether. Below, C6H5OC6H5. Here also no confusion. Both the groups are phenyl groups and hence we can name it as diphenyl ether. But coming to the third example, CH3OC2H5. Okay, now look at the alkyl groups. One is methyl group and the other one is ethyl group. So these two alkyl groups attached to the oxygen atom should be written alphabetically. So, which comes first, E or M? One is ethyl group and the other one is methyl group. So, E comes first if you look at the alphabetical order, and hence its name is ethyl methyl ether. Okay. Now, below, C2H5OC6H5. What are the two groups present here? One is ethyl group and the other one is phenyl group. So, one alkyl and one aryl group are attached to the oxygen atom. So, again here, E comes first and hence its name is ethyl phenyl ether. Okay, students, this is the way of giving common names to ethers. Some aromatic ethers have popular common names. Okay, so some aromatic ethers means one of the groups attached is aryl group. So, look at the examples given below. C6H5OCH3. So, how do you name it? One is methyl group, the other one is phenyl group. Alphabetically, if we look at the two names of the two groups, M comes first and P comes later. So, its name is methyl phenyl ether. It has a common name called as anisole, A-N-I-S-O-L-E. Okay, another example, C6H5O-C2H5. One is ethyl group and the other one is phenyl group. Here also, E comes first and P comes later, and hence its name is ethyl phenyl ether. Its common name is phenytoal. phenytoale. Okay, students, try to remember the common names of methyl phenyl ether and ethyl phenyl ether. Next, in IUPAC system, ethers are called as alkoxy alkanes. Underline this word. They are called as alkoxy alkanes. Okay, so what is this alkoxy alkane? Alkyl group having a smaller number of carbon atoms. Okay, try to understand this point, students. Alkyl group having smaller number of carbon atoms forms the part of the alkoxy group, while the larger alkyl group forms the parent chain. What, according to IUPAC system, we call ethers, students? They are called as alkoxy alkanes. Okay, so which part forms the alkoxy group? The alkyl group having smaller number of carbon atoms forms the part of alkoxy group, while the group having more number of carbon atoms forms the parent chain. Okay, now look at the examples. It will be easy for you to understand. CH3O, C2H5. One is methyl group having one carbon atom. The other one is ethyl group having two carbon atoms. Okay, see, alkyl group having smaller number of carbon atoms. Which is the alkyl group having smaller number of carbon atoms? Methyl group. So, it forms the part of alkoxy group. So, we will attach oxygen to CH3 and call it as methoxy group. Okay. And the alkyl group having more number of carbon atoms forms the parent chain. So, here the alkyl group with more number of carbon atoms is ethyl group. Okay. So, ethyl group forms the parent chain, and hence it is named as methoxy ethane. Okay. So, generally ethers are called as alkoxy alkanes in IUPAC system, students. Okay. So, the alkyl group having smaller number of carbon atoms forms the alkoxy group. So, CH3 forms the alkoxy group, and CH3 attached to oxygen is called as methoxy group, and the larger alkyl group forms the parent chain, and hence it is named as methoxy ethane. Next example, C2H5O, C6H5. Here the smaller alkyl group is ethyl group, and hence ethyl group attached with oxygen is called as ethoxy group, and the larger aryl group, that is C6H5 group, is the larger group which forms the parent chain, and hence it is called as ethoxy benzene. Third example, C6H5OCH3. So again, the smaller alkyl group is CH3. It is called it should form the alkoxy group, and hence it forms the methoxy group, and the larger aryl group is phenyl group. It forms the parent chain, and hence it is called as methoxy benzene. Okay, students, am I clear to you? Followed? Okay. Next, isomerism shown by ethers. Ethers show functional isomerism. Okay, that means here ethers are isomeric with monohydric alcohols. What is a monohydric alcohol, students? Which consists of only one OH group. Okay, so such alcohols are called as monohydric alcohols. So ethers are isomeric with monohydric alcohols. They both have the same general formula. So what is the general formula? CnH2n+2O, but they differ in the functional groups. For example, C2H6O. So with this formula, there exists dimethyl ether and also ethyl alcohol. So dimethyl ether has the molecular formula C2H6O, and ethyl alcohol also has the same molecular formula C2H6O. Hence these two are called as functional isomers. Next example, C4H10O. So with this general formula or with this molecular formula, there exists diethyl ether and C4H9OH. This is butanol or butyl alcohol. If you look at their molecular formula, both will have C4H10O. Hence, these two are functional isomers. Okay, students. So this is about isomerism shown by ethers. So carefully learn all the points in this video and please watch till the end of the video. That means complete video you watch and please take down the notes each and every point. Thank you.